Producers, it's Curtis King of Airbid.com here to answer a question. Is an email list still relevant for a producer in 2017? Wait, what?
Airbid.com.
Producers, I get asked this question very often because I think that producers get so confused and overwhelmed when they think about an email list. They think about it like, man, is that another website I have to maintain? Is it something where I gotta send out newsletters? I don't feel like typing. I'm not a copywriter. I don't like to type, man. I just like to sell beats and going about my life. I understand that, but if you're willing to invest just a little bit more energy into your email list, I'm guaranteeing you that not only will it increase your sales, but it will make sure that you have supporters for the rest of your production career. Now, an email list, what is an email list? An email list is basically a compilation of people who have either shown interest into buying your beats, maybe they've already bought beats, but basically it's a compilation of people who you are basically in charge of providing value for. Now, value can be the beats that you provide, or value can be information that you provide. We're gonna talk about that very briefly also. When I first got an email list, I was doing it the wrong way. I thought, man, I'm gonna get an email list full of all the people that kinda wanna buy beats, and then I'm gonna just spam them every single week and say, yo, got some new beats for you, man. And when I did that, I found that not only was it not making it to these customers didn't care about it because it was just way too salesy. It was way too direct. It was way too, yo, come buy my beats, I need money. It looked way too desperate. And what I learned is that you gotta finesse the email list. You gotta finesse it. Now, what kind of email providers can you go to? I love MailChimp, and I also love GetResponse. I've used both of them over the years, and I found that they both have their own benefits. I love GetResponse because it tells me whenever an email I put together, you know, it gives you a spam score to tell you if that email is going to make it to people's inboxes or if it's going to actually fall off the face of the earth into the spam folder. MailChimp is great because I've created email funnels, and that's a whole nother subject, probably a whole nother video. Email funnels are basically automated emails that go out over a span of a certain amount of days after somebody signs up for your email list. So imagine somebody getting a bunch of emails that point them in directions of other products that you provide for artists. It's really helpful. MailChimp has a great funnel system. And I feel like because I have made myself so informed about these platforms, I have been able to establish relationships and really just friendships. These are not just customers of mine. Same way you could be a fan of a song, but not necessarily a supporter of an artist. It's the same thing about my customers. They're not customers, they're supporters of mine. They became customers once they bought one beat. But they became a supporter once they saw my heart, once they saw that I was sending out emails that weren't just, hey man, I got 10 new beats, come check them out. I sent out emails that said, hey, SoundCloud might be shutting down, here's some helpful advice to you. And within the actual email, I said, here's some interesting points that you may want to check out, here's an article that I cited, and at the bottom of that I say, hey, by the way, I have 2 free new beats while I got your attention. That email had almost a 45% open rate, which is very high within email lists, especially if you have, you know, more than 1,000 emails. It's very high. So with that said, yes, emails are super relevant. They're even more relevant when your favorite websites decide to shut down. We just mentioned SoundCloud a couple videos ago. If SoundCloud shuts down, you're gonna be relying on your email. Hopefully you've been compiling emails, but you're gonna have to rely on that. Any website can basically shut down for a temporary time. Maybe it gets hacked, maybe the server goes down. It can happen to any website. It can happen to YouTube. I've seen it happen to YouTube. That being said, what are you gonna do? You better make sure that you have an email list full of supporters, full of people that you've invested so much value into that now they say, man, I love opening up your emails because I either get some motivation from you, Curtis, or I get some information I didn't know, or I get to see the 2 newest beats that you've done, or I get to have a heads up before everybody else in your particular network knows about your beats. There's so many benefits to being on an email list, but you gotta figure out what benefits you wanna offer. That's something else too. If you're going to start an email list and you wanna get emails, you're gonna have to have some kind of a reason why people need to sign up. Some producers say, hey, 10 free beats if you sign up for my email list today. Now that's kind of excessive. I wouldn't necessarily do that, but I understand why it works because emails are the most important thing that you can get from somebody. So I'll go into more detail in other videos about some email strategies and things to look out for, but for the most part, yes, you need an email list. You need to be compiling that thing like yesterday. You can go through all your old PayPal transactions and scoop up some emails and actually send them out a very welcoming and very nice and kind email that says, hey, would you mind if I added you to my email list? And then you'll find that a lot of people will actually respond to you. You gotta have an email list. An email list saved my business in 2015. I was going down a path where I was in a mood to make trap beats. All I wanted to do was make trap beats. What I found in my actual email though, when I sent out a survey, was that over 80% of my audience wanted hip hop beats. I almost derailed my business not knowing what my customers wanted, and the way that you know what they want is by having conversations within those emails. You're speaking to one person. Don't, hey y'all, I got, no, hey y'all, I got new beats. Hey you, I wanna have a conversation with you. I got some value that I think I can offer you, and if you need new beats, I got new beats. Once again, this is Curtis King of AirBit.com. I hope you found value in this information. You have a good one. Peace. AirBit.com.